about this book.
Sure.
We have Wonder Woman Dead Earth by DC. And this is a DC Black Label, and it's a prestige format. Can you tell me a little bit what that means?
Prestige format?
Yes.
Okay, so prestige format is it's going to be more like a graphic novel. It's got like cardstock cover. It's square bound instead of being stapled.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, besides that, there are no ads inside of the book. So you get this a piece that's more like something you buy out of a bookstore rather than a comic shop.
So it is a little bit bigger, and I'm actually going to tell you guys right here, I'm not a fan of the bigger books. I like the smaller, regular comic book size, so I have a hard time buying these.
Right.
But I'll put that aside for this review, because we're reviewing the book. It's also a DC Black Label, which is a more dark take on characters.
Right.
And they're standalone stories, correct?
Most of them are, yeah. Like 1 to 3 issue stories.
Yes. This one is brought to you by Daniel Warren Johnson. He's the artist and the writer of this book. He's done other titles such as Murder Falcon by Image Comics. That's one of his more recent ones.
Mm-hmm.
The prestige style format, this is a higher cover price. It's $6.99. So let's go ahead and actually talk about the story itself.
Sure.
And what we have going on. So we have Wonder Woman.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently the Earth has not had a good time.
Nope.
And in this story, and there's going to be some full spoilers in here, and maybe not full spoilers, but we will cover a few of them. Why don't you tell me a little bit of rundown about the book?
Sure. So we find the Earth is, you know, post-apocalyptic. There's been a nuclear holocaust, and we find this a group of boys who are out adventuring, probably in an area that they shouldn't be. But they're basically saying, look, this place hasn't been walked around for a long time. We're going to find something here. And sure enough, they find what they don't want, which is this huge creature. And this creature starts chasing them, and they fall into a cave, basically.
Yeah.
And when they fall in there, they basically wake up Diana Prince, the Wonder Woman, who's been, it looks like she's been sleeping for a long time.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of where it starts,
yes.
Right?
Now, let me tell you this. One of my criticisms about the Black Label books is that they've all been around Batman.
Most of them, they have.
Okay. So, here I get this title, and it says Wonder Woman.
Right.
All right? Great. Wonder Woman. It's about a different character. What cave is it?
It's the Bat Cave.
This is full spoilers, man. It's literally the Bat Cave that they fall into.
That's for sure.
And there is a dead Batman skeleton there. Like you said, this is a post-apocalyptic.
Just calm down.
What is this?
Post-apocalyptic.
This is a post-apocalyptic.
Nuclear Holocaust book.
This is a post-apocalyptic. Come on, man.
Apocalyptic.
Apocalyptic?
There we go.
This is a post-apocalyptic. Things do not work out well. It's a post-apocalyptic battle world. It's gone bad.
Right,
okay.
Right.
Everything looks horrible. It's, you know, you look outside, it looks like Fallout. Have you ever seen the game Fallout?
Right.
That's what this world looks like.
Scorched
There's only a
Earth.
Few survivors. It's scorched Earth.
Yeah.
So they accidentally wake her up, and she's part of the story. That's obviously about Wonder Woman. But they had to put Batman in there. They couldn't get away with one without Batman.
Yeah, that's true.
Even though he's dead and he doesn't say anything, it's the Batcave.
Yeah.
And Batman's right there. And I'm like, really? You couldn't do one without Batman?
Yeah.
And they couldn't. So right there, I was like, here we go again.
Right, right.
Well, give me a little bit more detail about the story. Not too much, just a little bit more after we go from there.
Sure. Okay, so basically, you know, these, you know, after she saves these kids, they take her back to where they live. And long story short, it's a compound where the last of the humans live.
Yeah.
And they basically trick her. They're capturing her.
Yeah.
And, she, you know, long story short, she gets put inside of a gladiator pit.
Yeah. So Wonder Woman has always had a love for the human race.
Absolutely.
That's what she's sworn to protect.
Yep.
And this is what this book is about. Mm-hmm. Even though that the people are tricking her or whatnot, she's still sworn to protect them type thing. And she wants to protect them, and that's what she kind of struggles with in this book. She actually doesn't struggle with it. The people that she actually protects are the ones who struggle with
right.
it.
Right. How can you still save us?
Exactly. I like that dynamic of the book. I like that they kind of went there and they have these people in a different situation. Obviously, the world is not what it used to be. Everything's gone to hell, type thing. There's only a few people left, and there's creatures and monsters out there. And besides her, I don't see anyone else, you know, coming to play that is a hero.
No.
That is able to defend said mankind type thing. So she might be the first one in a long time. One thing I do notice, in this book, they do not even mention how everything happened.
No, they don't.
They gloss right over it. And then she asks these kids what happened. They go, I don't know what happened before we were born.
Right.
And there's no mention of how it went bad. And I kind of like that because I don't need a lot of backstory. Like I said, these are standalone books. They kind of just go and you can read them and you don't have to have that backstory. So I enjoy that. The ending is setting up the series. It's a 3-issue series. Mm-hmm. And pretty much at the end of this book, the first one is all set up for what she wants to be, which is the hero.
Right.
And we'll see going forward if she is the hero. If the people accept her to be the hero, or if they revolt against her. Because, like I said, there's a little bit of there's a clash between that in this book. There's some other characters that are introduced that are famous from the Wonder Woman storyline. Those are fun to see in here.
Absolutely.
I'm pretty sure they'll probably introduce more, maybe a dead Robin or something like that. I don't know. In the next book, I don't know. I'll get Batman in there. It's very important.
For sure.
The one thing I didn't like that didn't fit very well, and I look at the artwork. When I first look at the artwork, I was like, I don't know if it does it for me.
Yeah.
And then it mainly got to the point to where I didn't mind it, but the Wonder Woman character looked different.
Yeah.
And all the other stuff around it, the environment, I thought it looked really good. Mm-hmm. And I think the artwork looks good, but the way Wonder Woman herself is drawn, that kind of took me out of it a little bit. Do you feel kind of the same way? The
same way. I really wasn't a fan of the artwork. But like you said, I didn't mind because the writing was so well.
Mm-hmm.
I was very engaged in the story. I wanted to see what happened next. But like you said, this does not match what my understanding or view of Wonder Woman is. It's kind of a cartoony, you know, style meets comic book style. Yeah. And I've never been a fan of that. But I understand it's the writer who's doing the drawing as well. And that's hard enough in itself.
Yeah.
But I really don't think it matches this character or even the story, really.
Even the character that they introduced, the Wonder Woman character, mm-hmm. the other character from her universe, I actually thought the artwork on that character was pretty good.
I saw that. I was like,
oh, it looked good. It made sense and stuff. It literally comes down to just literally the Wonder Woman character herself. Just didn't have that Amazonian type Wonder Woman feel to her that I'm so used to seeing all the time.
Right.
All the other character animation that's in this book, you know, the arenas, the background, the other characters, I thought were just fine. Mm-hmm. It was just her in general. I was like, it could have been a little bit different.
So interesting. So
that's a minor tweak right there.
So if you were to take her out of the story, everything else would have seemed fine and in place.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I think just the character animation that she
had. I think it's a fair assessment.
Yeah. All in all, I enjoyed the book. Mm-hmm. I'm curious to see where they go. I'm not a huge Wonder Woman person. I don't read a lot of her books. I don't think I have any of her books. And actually, this is your copy. I borrowed it.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoyed it. I don't know if I'll get number 2 because it's a bigger book.
Sure.
And
you can borrow mine.
I'm just biased against these bigger prestige format books. I don't have a box that they fit in. And I always get a little confused because DC Black Label does both.
They do.
They do actually do 3 different ones. They do the regular
floppies,
yep. And then they do a smaller version of this than this size. So yeah. I mean, just pick one, stick with it. Right? But I enjoyed it. I thought it was a good story.
I did too.
I'm looking forward to borrowing your copy and reading number 2 and seeing where it goes from there.
For sure. I don't mind the prestige format as long as they keep coming out with good content.
Yeah.
So far, most of the stuff they've been coming out with Black Label, they've been killing it.
Yes.
And so if you put out good artwork, good content, I'm gonna buy it, even if it is the larger format. So I don't mind it so much. But I really can't wait for issue number 2. I enjoyed this a lot more than I thought I was gonna enjoy it. And hey, this guy is a really good writer, and I'm on board for it.
Yeah, very good. Yeah, I like the story. I thought the story was really good. And of course, we did get another Batman appearance. So there you go.